Hi everyone, I am Anvita. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to explain about generations of computer. This video is very useful for competitive exams, also Olympiad.
There are 5 generations of computer which are categorized on the base of major technological developments that change the way of operation of computers.
Let's go to the first generation. First generation, 1940 to 1956. The computers of this generation used vacuum tubes, which were huge. The first generation used machine language, which is a low-level programming language understood by computers. UNIAC and ENIAC are the examples of first-generation computer. UNIAC was the first commercial computer delivered to the US Census Bureau in 1951. Features of first-generation computers. Vacuum tubes were the only electronic component available during those days.
These computers were the fastest calculating devices of their time. They could perform the calculations in milliseconds.
Types of first generation computers. Vacuum tube emitted large amounts of heat and bound off frequently.
They are very costly, non-portable and required constant maintenance.
Bulky in size, they weighed over 30 tons. Let's go to the second generation computer. Second generation computer, 1956 to 1963. Vacuum tubes were replaced by transistors. Second generation computers used assembly language instead of machine language. The first computers of second generation were delivered to the atomic energy industry. IBM 1401, PDF-1 and Atlas are the examples of second generation computers. Features of second generation computer. They were smaller in size as compared to the first generation computer. The computers in the generation reduced to the calculation time for milliseconds to the microsecond. They introduced assembly language and operating system software. Drawbacks of second generation computer. They were still costly and required frequent maintenance. Air condition were also required. Let's go to the third generation. Third generation computers, 1964 to 1971. The major breakthrough computer technology came in the third generation,
1964,
of integrated circuit.
The transistors were replaced by integrated circuits,
known as semiconductor chips. The third generation computers could perform billions of instructions in few seconds. The efficiency of this generations of computer was also more than the previous generations. IBM 360, PDF 6600, ICL 19000, Honeywell 6000 series are these examples of third generation computers. Features of third generation computers. These computers were able to
reduce and calculation speed from milliseconds to nanoseconds. The computers of this generation used operating system, hence permitting multitasking or parallel processing. They were smaller in size and required less maintenance as compared to the previous generation.
Computers became accessible to common audience because of smaller size, portability and fair cost. Drawbacks of third generation computers. Air conditions are required in many cases. Highly sophisticated technology was required for the manufacturing of integrated chips. Let's go to the fourth generation. Fourth generation computer, 1917 to 2010. The fourth generation of computers began in 1972. In this generation, integrated circuits were replaced by microprocessor.
A microprocessor is a small chip that does all the processing in a computer.
Computers are used very large scale integrated VLSI circuit. The computer became so powerful,
can handle many operations simultaneously.
IBM 370 series are the examples of this generation of computers. Through the 1980s and 2000s, personal computers and desktops became
cheap and were installed in offices, schools and homes.
Fourth generation computers. They were much faster in the calculations than the previous generation. Also, the concept of internet was introduced in the generation. They were portable because of their small size. All the high-level languages like C++, etc. were used in the generation. Drawbacks of the fourth generation. Highly sophisticated technology was required for the manufacturing of the microprocessor on a large scale and volume. Let's go to the fifth generation computer. Fifth generation computer, 2010 to present. In fifth generation computers, the VLSI technology became ultra large scale integrated ULSI technology. The fifth generation computers,
as those used in a satellite, use artificial intelligence and can work on their own without the help of a user.
Generation computers are Star 1000, Cray XMB supercomputer, DEC-10, PDF-11, Cray are the examples of 5th generation computers. If you like this video, like, share, comment and subscribe my